Again, a circuit from my book Small Scale Solar Energy Systems that I took from the market, because the circuit, a certain circuit in this book, was not reproducible. Well, I want to show that circuit that was not reproducible. I try to make it again. You see how it looked in real, complete mess, of course. Anyway, but the whole setup was, in my opinion, quite good, and this is how it all was made. I hope this will give some idea about what I made in those days a few years ago. Consisted of a 741 that I use as a voltage comparator, and that voltage comparator drived a relay, and that relay switched on or off the 220 volt power supply lead. So here you see the output from the 741 when the voltage at the input, at the sense and the fixed voltage differs, goes too low compared for a 24 volt car battery lead acid. This transistor was driven, it drove the relay into a certain position, and then the power transformer here that could make 10 ampere switched on, and a power rectifier, a power capacitor, and then in the house all the lighting was switched from the battery here to the transformer here. And at the same time, I had to make a certain circuit with which I could reactivate it all, and that was made here by a transformer with 10 windings here and 2000 windings here. I rectify that AC, because here it's all AC, and then I also activated a relay that was switched to the rest position or the activated position. So that was the way to switch from the solar panel energy, full 24 volts car battery, when it was drained out. I switched via the 741 voltage comparator to the power transformer. So, but I tried to make this circuit again, and it was not reproducible. So, this is only a video to show how you can make such a thing and change it or repair it or make a better circuit. It was quite complicated, but it had it functioned very well for approximately 5 years or so. So let's pan over. I realize that this explanation is not very clear, but anyway, important to tell, for instance, that when you want to use a 741 chip as a voltage comparator, you need a very stabilized voltage, and that was realized here with this transistor and the Zener diode. The voltage at the switch chip had to be completely constant under all circumstances, even when the 24 volt battery was getting to its lowest voltage position. Perhaps that could be a lesson from this circuit. Anyway, I wish you luck, and I had a rectification from the circuit on the final page that I made, because one of the potentiometers burned out on the longer term. So this was a rectification from the circuit that I've published earlier. So it needs a lot of study to make it again and make it function in a proper way. Anyway.